It's almost time for the week the Suncoast has been planning for years. The World Rowing Championships are set to begin on Saturday at Nathan Benderson Park, and more than 40,000 people are expected to attend. Public Relations Manager Max Winnix is here to tell us everything that's been going on. We've missed you, Max.
Yeah, it's fitting to be here on Throwback Thursday. And Stephanie, I will try to be less snarky today than I was when I was a host on this show.
Okay, so yes. I know you're expected to behave in your public relations role.
Yes, yes.
Well, I am so excited about that free opening night ceremony. Tell me about that.
In one word, it's going to be spectacular. We will have some of the more reputable entertainment acts from this area participating at the opening ceremony, which begins at 7 o'clock this Saturday night at Nathan Benderson Park. The gates open at 5, but it is something for everybody. You're going to see the West Coast Black Theater Troupe. You're going to see Ja Movement Reggae Band, Circus Sarasota. I could go on and on. The end of the night, you'll see a spectacular fireworks display over Nathan Benderson Park, and it's really to pay homage to the athletes from 69 countries. You know, we have 900 plus athletes. Then you add in their coaches and support staff, close to 1,700 people from 69 different countries in this event. So it's going to be awesome.
It does sound awesome. And then the rowing begins on Sunday.
That's correct.
Tell me about that.
So this is basically the Super Bowl or the World Cup for the sport of rowing, and it's taking place in our own backyard. Some of the footage you're seeing now is from the training that's been taking place at Nathan Benderson Park for the past week and a half or so. One of your photojournalists was out there yesterday capturing. This is the Poland men's eight boat right there. But again, this is the marquee international regatta of the year. It's the first time in 23 years this event is being held in the United States. So for our area, it's a really big
deal. What an honor. Yeah. And the races are every day?
The races are September 24th through October 1st. They get underway usually at 10 in the morning, with the exception of the final weekend, which is referred to as championship weekend. Mm-hmm. Those races begin closer to 9, but they conclude around 2 o'clock every afternoon.
What do I need to know as a spectator? I mean, how do I park? Where do I get my tickets?
Sure.
How does all that work?
You know, first and foremost, as a spectator, you don't have to know a thing about rowing to come out and enjoy this event. It is going to be a huge festival with food trucks, vendors, live entertainment, you name it. But thank you very much for bringing up parking and other issues. Parking is going to take place in what we call the North Lot. That is adjacent to the mall at University Town Center. It's where the Circus Sarasota tent has been the last couple of years for their winter show.
So that big open
grassy area.
So there's a lot of space.
Yes, and there will be shuttles going to the venue and back to the parking lot for people with mobility issues. It's about a 7-minute walk if you want to do it. We encourage people to walk, but again, those shuttles are there if you need them.
Well, and, you know, a lot of people are talking about that park, of course, is something that people use. Mm-hmm. Are you going to be able to still use the park if you're not going to the event?
So the actual island, which is called Regatta Island at Nathan Benderson Park, which is where the finish tower is, the venue itself is off limits throughout the competition. However, the rest of Nathan Benderson Park will open or will reopen each day 90 minutes after competition. So if you're somebody who enjoys your walks around the lake at dusk you're still able to do that.
Well, we want somebody to pull for, and I understand the U.S. team is a real powerhouse.
Yeah, the U.S., they have over 100 athletes in the World Rowing Championships. Their biggest boat, or their most well-known boat, is that eight boat. You saw the Polish team, but it's the women's eight.
Oh,
and they've won championships in the past.
It is a
correct?
Dynasty. They have won gold at the past several Olympic Games, at the past several World Rowing Championships. So that's the boat really, really to watch out for everybody who's going to be coming out and rooting on the United States.
So you were mentioning there are other things to do other than just watching rowing while you're there.
Yeah.
What else can we do?
To elaborate a little bit more on the Fan Fest area, that's where you are going to find various food trucks, vendors, live entertainment, including several great entertainment acts, bands. I know we have to, you know, really show that we are welcoming the world. We have an Irish dance team coming out, a Ukrainian dance team coming out. Again, if you don't know a thing about rowing, you're really going to have a good time in the Fan Fest area. And everybody should drive by on Cattleman Road now and see what the park looks like. It has been transformed into something really phenomenal.
It is gorgeous with the flags that are up and the banners. It looks really neat.
The impact on the Suncoast. Mm-hmm. Wow, this is huge.
Yeah, I mean, the bid was awarded, as all of you may recall, since we reported, or you reported.
You were one of us at the time.
Yes, yes. But the bid was rewarded back in 2013, and it is, you know, I can't believe that Saturday, this is finally happening. We're expecting a $25 million economic impact. I bet it's going to exceed that for Sarasota and Manatee County. So everybody's going to benefit from that.
Oh, it looks gorgeous. I'm so excited. And the first day of competition for the World Rowing Championship is this Sunday, September 24th. It's going to run all week long, and the finals are going to be on Sunday, October 1st. For more schedules and information, just go to their website. Everything is there. And coming up, Mickey recaps the red carpet looks from the Emmys.